Hey you guys, it's Peter and welcome to my channel, Peter Likes Books. And today I am so excited because I am doing my very first book review of 2019. I started the year off with a really great book, so I'm happy about that. If you watch my videos consistently, you know I didn't come anywhere near meeting my Goodreads goal last year, which was I think 100 or 101. I ended up reading like 47, 48 books. So I again set my Goodreads goal at 100. I have gotten off to a really good start. I finished one book. I'm halfway through a paper book that I'm reading. I'm halfway through a physical book that I'm reading, and I am halfway through my next Audible book. I'm currently listening to One of Us is Lying by Karen McManus. I thought after 71 weeks on the New York Times bestseller list, maybe I should finally give it a try since it's been on TBRs of mine forever. But today's book review is about the book Sadie. Here, I'll put the little picture up. Sadie by Courtney Summers. Now, I had heard a lot about this book. I had gotten a lot of recommendations from people to read this book. They said, you like mysteries, you like thrillers, you like young adult. This is kind of a mixture of all of that. I guess, like, as a booktuber, I don't really know the difference between young adult and new adult. I always kind of assumed that, like, new adult was maybe, like, a little bit more mature than young adult. So I'm not really sure where this book lies as far as, putting it into a specific genre, if that makes sense. I don't really care. Like, it was a good book to me. I will tell you that, trigger warning, there's a lot of, allusions to certain kinds of abuse, specifically sexual abuse, in this book. I think the way that the author, Courtney Summers, handled it was done very, very well. I was impressed with it. She doesn't go into specific details. She just alludes to it. That being said, I do want to say that at the beginning of this video. I ended up giving I ended up giving this book on Goodreads 5 stars, but I would have probably given it a rating of, I don't know, let's say like 92%. Can you hear my voice? I've been sick forever. 92% maybe. I mean, it was a good book. It was definitely a good book to start the year off with. Was it the best book I've read in the world? No. Would I recommend it to other people? Yes, I already have. I thought it was that well done, but I will tell you this. I listened to the Audible version of it, and the Audible version of it very much plays out like a podcast or like a radio show that you're listening to. There are several actors and actresses in it. I mean, like, there's a whole cast of characters when you listen to the audiobook. And when you're listening to it, it goes back and forth between the main character, Sadie, her talking and telling her story, and an actual radio show, a podcast called The Girls. Audible version is just fantastic. It's like listening to a live radio show, which if you watch my vlogs, you know that I grew up listening to old radio shows like The Shadow and Fibber McGee and Molly. Like, my mom and I used to listen to those tapes. So this very much felt like that to me. Plus, I also love podcasts. And I just recently talked about a book on here about the Golden State Killer that was an Audible exclusive, which is called Evil Has a Name by Paul Holes, who was the investigator on that case. This plays out very much like that. Like, it feels like a true crime podcast. So if you're interested in something like that, the Audible version is fantastic. Now, let me read to you guys what this is about in case you have no clue what the book Sadie is about whatsoever, because I have to tell you, what I thought it was about and what it ended up being about are two completely different things. So Sadie, a missing girl on a journey of revenge, a serial-like podcast following the clues she's left behind, and an ending you won't be able to stop talking about. Well, I don't know about that. Sadie hasn't had an easy life. Growing up on her own, she's been raising her sister Maddie in an isolated small town, trying her best to provide a normal life and keep their heads above water. But when Maddie is found dead, Sadie's entire world crumbles. After a somewhat botched police investigation, Sadie is determined to bring her sister's killer to justice and hits the road, following a few meager clues to find him. When Wes McCrae, a radio personality working on a segment about small forgotten towns in America, overhears Sadie's story at a local gas station, he becomes obsessed with finding the missing girl. He starts his own podcast as he tracks Sadie's journey, trying to figure out what happened, hoping to find her before it's too late. Courtney Summers has written the breakout book of her career. Sadie is propulsive and harrowing and will keep you riveted until the last page. And I would agree with that. I mean, it did totally keep me, like, peaked until the very, very, end. Like, I really wanted to know what was going to happen. I will say I did not see the ending coming. I really, really didn't. The ending was not what I expected. I don't think that, I'm not going to ruin it for people. I'm not a spoiler channel. I don't think that it will, I don't know. It was just kind of anticlimactic to me, the ending of it, so to speak. I didn't really guess that's what was going to happen, but at the same time, I really didn't know how it was going to end. So I don't know that I was surprised either. Sadie is an unforgettable character, and if you've watched my videos for a long time, you know I am somebody that falls in love with characters. I could care less about plot. The fact that the plot was so interesting, and it was this journey of this girl, basically a journey of redemption through small town America. You know, it was very, very well done. It was very interesting. There are parts in there where she kind of like stalks people through Instagram, which was funny. I mean, there was a lot of like current day stuff woven through with like things that like you would have known from a mystery from like 20 years ago. It was really, really well done. And I think it was actually probably, I don't know much about the writing process of Courtney Summers, and I haven't read any interviews by her, but there had to have been quite a bit of, I would say, research that went into this book, because just there were certain things that, as somebody that reads a lot of true crime, stood out to me. I was like, this reads like a true crime, like a fiction true crime, if that makes sense. I thought it was really, really well done. So for that reason, I gave it 5 stars. You definitely won't be disappointed. Do I think it was the greatest book ever? No. I did notice that on the cover when I was just making a screenshot to put it up here, that AJ Finn, who wrote The Woman in the Window, which was one of my top, I think, 3 favorite books of last year, he put on there something like a riveting read or whatever. And it definitely is. I mean, I was never bored. I was never like, oh God, can this book just go any faster? I was always interested till the very end. And the one thing that I love about it is that there's constantly introduction of new characters. And even the characters that are not like new characters, they kind of change over the course of time, and you're really interested in each person. This is a book of characterization. It is fantastically well written, and I was super impressed, and I can't wait to see what she has next. So let me know if you've read it, what you think in the comment section below. I love you guys. I have tomorrow a very, very fun book haul for you. I haven't done a book haul on this channel in a long time, so I will see you then. I love you. Bye.